Our guest is Brian Rich. He is the author of Shift and Reset, Strategies for Addressing Serious Issues in a Connected Society. It's a roadmap for companies that have a message, they want to do something, they want to change something, but they need to understand what is a very different media landscape. Very, very different. Let's get a roadmap. Let's get, I know you're going to have to get the book to really get the whole thing, but Brian, I'd like to know, let's say, you know, I have an idea that really is going to change the world. And my company's been working in obscurity for years, and I decided I want to make a difference, and I'm going to have to use new media to do it. Where do I start?
Sure. Well, so there's a couple of steps in the process of getting people engaged and to take the actions you want or the behaviors you want. The first one is awareness, which, you know, I think a lot of people confuse awareness with everything else, right? So people, first of all, need to become aware of not just who you are, but what you're doing and its relevance in their lives. But then immediately on the heels of that is framing, right? So you have to change the way that people are thinking about whatever issue you're dealing with. So if you sell a smoothie, something healthy to drink, and you want people to drink that smoothie, you're not really selling just the product. You're actually selling a set of behaviors that make people healthier, an investment of time and money and, you know, understanding of all that. So you have to make them aware of the fact that, you know, they could be drinking healthier. But then you also need to help them understand, you know, why the situation they're in needs to change in a certain way. Follow that up with education. People really need to know. So the problem with awareness is it's fleeting, right? You, ooh, puppies. Ooh, I love that. Ooh, I'm scared of that. Ooh, I'm, you know, social pressure from, you know, the fact that all my neighbors are doing X, Y, and Z. That stuff wears off, and we have tens of thousands of competing messages that are coming at us all the time. So you really have to embed knowledge, understanding of what it is that these issues are and these products are. Once you establish that, then you just need to direct people down this different path. You need to, you know, show them how and where to buy the product. You need to teach them how to drink it. Sounds really crazy, right? But do you need to shake it up before you open it? And if you don't, are you going to miss a lot of the benefits? Do you need to drink it for 6 weeks before you're going to see the benefits of it? Do you need to also exercise, right? That setting of expectations and that directing of very explicit behaviors is super important. All that stuff is outlined in the book, but the key, again, is, you know, you need to know the audience, not just who you're trying to reach, but the life they're leading and the opportunity to change the behavior, the opportunity to insert what you're doing into an existing pattern of behavior. So if you're Uber, right, you know that people are already getting from point A to point B, and you know that it would be way better if I didn't have to stick my arm out when I leave my building in New York City and hope that a taxi comes by, as opposed to having a vehicle come to me wherever I am, whenever I want, right? So you're not training someone on something entirely new. You're just modifying what they're doing in a little bit. But then, you know, also you're going to have to rewire the way they think about this stuff. And so that means changing the language that they use, right? So I may think of a smoothie as, you know, healthy and, ooh, I don't like healthy stuff, right? You know, it's all about green stuff and it's going to be tart and, you know, it's going to be expensive or whatever the perceptions are that people come in with. You need to understand that so you can effectively change the language and say, you know, no, a smoothie is about X, or, you know, Ubering becomes a verb in people's lives. So, yeah, you start with understanding the audience, but then you got to, you know, move past awareness, which is what most of us focus on. And you get into that reframing and that knowledge building, that education. And once you have that, now people are hooked. And then it's just a matter of, how do you want them to activate? How easy can you make it for them to activate? How can you sustain the quality of that activation over time, right? Because if I have a great first experience and then I have a crappy second experience with you, you know, I'm probably not going to come back for a third. But if I have 10, 15, 20 good experiences and then I have one bad experience because just whatever happens, I'll give you another shot. You know, we build up some resilience as you know, as humans, as individuals, and we're not thinking that way. We're thinking everything again as this, ooh, awareness, and, you know, wow, people talked about us, they buzzed about us, but did it sell more product? Did it get more people to the polls? Did it increase donations? Did it, you know, reduce the number of hours people sat on the couch eating pork rinds instead of, you know, walking around and lowering their blood pressure, right? There are measurable changes, and it's not in awareness or clicks or social interactions. It has to be tied to these behaviors.